Let me come to you immediately, Paola. Of course, as I said a little bit earlier, you remind me of the star of the 1982 Italian team that won the World Cup, Paola Rossi. Related to you?
It's not related to me, but I've been a fan since when I was young of Paola Rossi.
Very interesting, very interesting. Now, let me ask you about what you do. You are the manager of Terra Freak. What is Terra Freak? Am I, in fact, saying it the right way?
Thank you very much, Shaka. Terra Africa, that's how we call it, is a partnership. Terra from land, and Africa is our region. It's a partnership that started in 2005, and it's a partnership between many African countries. Right now we have 24 African countries, various donors, various organizations of the United Nations like FAO, UNDP, UNEP, different banks, the World Bank, IFAD, the Africa Development Bank, NGO, civic society. And it's a partnership to address the issues of land degradation and finding solutions, particularly looking at the possibility of expanding sustainable land and water management in Africa. And what is really the beauty of it is that it's an Africa partnership. I'm just the coordinator from the World Bank side for Terra Africa, but it's actually Terra Africa is led by the African Union, NEPAD.
NEPAD.
Yeah.
The new development for Africa's development.
That's correct. And I'm here also representing them right now, but I hope that one day they will be able to come to your show themselves and talk about all the good things that we have been doing together and working in a partnership since 2005.
Now you say that you coordinate it. Does that also mean that it is in fact headquartered right here in Washington, D.C.?
No, no, no. The Terra Africa partnership started in 2005 and the Terra Africa Secretariat was with the World Bank until 2009. But since 2009, it moved to NEPAD. So the Terra Africa Secretariat is with NEPAD in Pretoria.
Actually,
I'm coordinating the contributions from the World Bank.
I see. Midlands between Pretoria and Johannesburg, that's where the NEPAD Secretariat actually
correct.
Is, if I remember correctly. So what can you tell us about its accomplishments so far? Are there any accomplishments that you're in a position to talk about?
Yes, yeah, definitely. And so the Terra Africa Partnership started trying to look at what are the major issues. Why, if sustainable land management is an important solution to the issues of land degradation affecting more than 60% of the land in Africa, why we don't see it more, you know, more adopted in Africa? And there are many answers to that. And basically, the Terra Africa Partners decided that it needed to tackle the issues under three main pillars, if you want. One is that the issue is multi-sectorial. You cannot have one single agency in one single country to work on issues related to land degradation. It needs to be between the Minister of Agriculture, Forest, Environment, Livestock, etc. So you need to build coalition around these issues. And we have built more than 24 coalitions in the 24 countries in Africa right now. You need also to do a little bit more study about how you can reverse the land degradation. There are a lot of very excellent techniques, but can they be applied everywhere? Shall they, the good success that we see in West Africa, can we apply them in East Africa? A lot of farmers have an incredible knowledge that is not recorded anywhere on books that needs to be brought up, brought to the surface. So there is a major pillar on knowledge management. And I'm happy to share with you that Terra Africa produced this, which is considered sort of a manual of the sustainable land management technologies from all over Africa, that is now very appreciated and used by extension agencies all over Africa. And we have produced a lot of our knowledge, really going into the countries and talking to farmers. For example, one of the best examples is conservation agriculture in Zambia. Mm-hmm. It's amazing what Zambia and Zimbabwe have been able to achieve. And just talking to the farmers, and the farmers have spread this technology with just talking to each other. So we are documenting all these successes. And so that's the second pillar, is the knowledge, capturing the knowledge that exists and is not documented formally. And the third pillar, it's really investing more, being able to invest more. And we are very happy to report that with the Terrafrica partnership, we have been able to really put into sustainable land management almost $3 billion in Africa. And so far, just with the part of the World Bank, more than 250,000 hectares of land was very degraded and now been recovered and become really productive. So this is just one of the example of successes of Terrafrica.
What about the bottom line? Do you have adequate funding for what you need to do?
That's a very important question. The sustainable land management, the needs are so big that I think that there is, really governments and donors need to put additional funding into it. Mm-hmm. But a lot also can be done with what the countries have. It's really a change in the mentality that is needed. If we are able to get people to understand that sustainable land management, it's really about the triple wins. Sustainable land management can improve productivity of the land, which is the bottom line of what we all want. And at the same time, make the land more resilient to climate change. And at the same time, it can also help to reduce the climate change impacts on the land. We'll see that little by little, it can be done. And there are incredible examples of, like in Niger, where no money has been put by governments or by donors, but the farmers themselves started to recuperate certain dunes that were completely degraded and just started planting some trees. Mm. And now you can see really the difference on the hills and the dunes that have been treated and the ones that have not treated. And this brings a lot of advantages in terms of less soil erosion, more water coming down from the dunes to the productive areas in a sort of a spontaneous way, mm-hmm. when it's possible.
You talk about the need for fundamental changes, perhaps in people's attitudes and, one might add, mindsets. What have you been able to do in order to deal with some of those issues?
The mindset shift is maybe one of the most difficult ones. And what we have noticed is that the best way for people to capture the message is when they see somewhere that has been done.
They see results.
They see results. They visit the farms where this has been done. They talk to other farmers that have done this and they have achieved a lot of benefits. So what Terrafrica is trying to do is, first of all, to identify these champions, these leaders that have done things and that are interested in spreading their knowledge, in receiving people to visit their own farms. So we are organizing a lot of visits. And when this is not possible, because of course the visit can be expensive, mm-hmm. from one country to another, but it's enough even from one district, mm-hmm. to another district. But when that's not possible, we are also trying to organize. We have an incredible work done under our communication, to document all these successes.
You have 20 seconds.
So that we can show through the TV, through internet, all the successes to people that cannot travel.
I see.
And the third way is through some more formal training and exchange of experiences.
I see.